way that's satisfying, but that also serves the story, but not in the way that it seems like you have to satisfy the story. So, you know, the mother and the daughter haven't seen each other for a long time. A lot of very scary things go down over the course of the book. So I knew that if they were going to have a reckoning, that I didn't want either of them to narrate it. And I couldn't figure out who was going to narrate the scene, and I really wanted to introduce somebody new late in the book. And again, the chorus was like, you can't introduce somebody new as a narrator late in the book. And then I was like, why? It's my book. You know, I can do anything I want. It's like, that's the beauty of making art, is that you create your own world and you make your own choices. And I was like, and in my world, one can have a new narrator whenever you need one. So I introduced a new one, and it worked out really well. And interestingly, people came up to me after the book came out, and they were saying how much they loved the surprise of having a new perspective on these characters who they'd come to know over the course of the book. So I think actually when you take a risk and risk failure or risk going against the conventional expectations, you may find that readers are more receptive than